Now in this Fit Coach Update video, I want to talk about strides or leg turnover training. If you're not familiar with what strides are or leg turnover, go to the resources section of Run Team, head to the workout how-to videos, and you'll see a video here on leg speed or stride workouts. Take a look at that. It does a deeper dive with some videos of people doing strides, so you get a real idea of what that workout is about. But in a nutshell, strides are short but fast repetitions with long recoveries in between. They usually last less than 30 seconds. You are to run quickly but relaxed. So this is not all out sprinting. It's not a sprint workout, it's a stride. A stride is run quickly but relaxed with excellent running form and a fast cadence. That is what we do in a stride. This is not a heavy breathing workout. Our goal is not to build up a lot of lactic acid as like you would in a sprint workout. In fact, we don't want any lactic acid buildup because lactic acid buildup interferes with the neuromuscular system, and that means you can't run quickly with a fast cadence because your neuromuscular system isn't operating correctly. You know you're building up too much lactic acid when you begin to lose your breath and you cannot recover it in the recovery interval between a stride. If that's the case and you're getting out of breath, slow down the strides a little bit because you're going too fast. We run these by effort. I know we're so pace oriented, but this is one of those workouts that you do by effort. You'll run quicker than 5K pace, but I really don't want you to worry about pace. Run them by effort, quick but relaxed, never straining but fast. You can time these if you want. I do it. When I go to do a leg speed workout, I usually do that on a track. I'll time myself for 100 meters and then I do my recovery jog. So 100 meter stride, recovery jog. But I don't force the pace based on the time I see on the watch. I'm just simply recording how long does it take me. I usually start and I get a little bit faster with each successive stride, but I'm not straining to do that. The pace is just sort of coming out. So it's an important thing to remember with the stride workout. The purpose, as I mentioned, is to improve your neuromuscular coordination. I want you to learn how to run quickly with a nice, light, fast leg turnover and excellent running form. This is sort of like basic running 101, learning to run quickly but controlled. It's a great skill to develop as a runner, which is why you'll see stride workouts within your training plan from time to time. They are really great for improving cadence, and we've had discussions about cadence on the message boards, and I know it's a popular topic because our watches now can tell us what our cadence is, and because all of that, so the articles came out a few years ago saying that every runner should achieve a 180 steps per minute cadence, and so people became more aware of it. As I mentioned in those posts in the message boards, I'm not dogmatic about you have to be at 180, but if you would like to improve your cadence, say you're at 160 and you'd like to get it to 170, it's a reasonable increase in cadence, these are perfect opportunities to do it, these stride workouts. You can do those workouts and then monitor your cadence on your watch. You can even download a tempo or a cadence app, like a metronome, and so you can work on a faster cadence during that. So during these strides, it's a wonderful opportunity to do a little cadence training with these stride workouts. They also help you to get used to fast running before you begin speed workouts. So if you haven't done speed workouts in a long time, or you find you get injured doing speed workouts, then introducing stride workouts before you move to speed workouts is a great way to condition the body and get it ready for these speed workouts coming in the future. A few weeks of strides really is a great prep leading into any speed training you may do. They really help in improving your finishing kick. Obviously, you want to sprint at the end of races to improve your time or maybe be competitive with some other person in the race, and working on this in strides is a great way to improve your finishing kick. You kind of have this running form and ability you can go to at the end of races because you've practiced it in training. They are also wonderful for increasing your pace when you feel slow. I know sometimes we just feel slow in our running, feel like we're no longer fast, or we never were fast. How do we get faster? These are a great thing to introduce into your training to help improve, help you not feel slow anymore, but to feel faster. As a result, you can do these as frequently as you like. I know that I have some specific leg speed workouts in training plans, but I want you to know that if you want to improve your cadence or your finishing kick or you're getting ready to do some speed work or you just feel slow and you want to feel faster, any of those things, feel free to introduce strides anytime you like. Now use common sense. I always feel like anytime I say anytime you like, somebody will be an extreme person and they'll start doing strides every day and do a ton of them and they'll end up getting injured. I don't mean that. I mean, if you want to start adding a few more strides into your weekly schedule than you may see in the stride workouts in your plan, that's perfectly okay to do. You can add 6 to 10 repetitions lasting 10 to 20 seconds. Again, we're keeping these short so there's no lactic acid buildup, with long recoveries, maybe 45 seconds to 60 seconds recovery. And you can do that within or after any easy run in your training plan as long as you're feeling good. So if you're feeling tired, don't do this. This is, when you're feeling tired on an easy run, that usually indicates you need a little more recovery. But if you feel normal, you feel good, feel free either within, so maybe halfway through your easy run, you begin to accelerate for 10 to 20 seconds, then jog easy for a minute, accelerate again, you introduce it within your run. Or like a lot of us did in high school and college, when we finish an easy run, then we'll do these strides, maybe stride for 10 to 20 seconds, maybe walk back to your starting point, stride again. You can add 6 to 10 of these at the end of an easy run. It's a really great way to get a little bit more fast training in, work on those concepts we talked about before. They're very easy on the musculoskeletal system. So this is one of the interesting things about strides. They work the neuromuscular system, but they don't stress the muscles, the tendons, the ligaments, and the fascia the way speed workouts do or extended running fast does. So they're usually very easy on the musculoskeletal system. Now again, you have to use common sense and don't suddenly start doing strides all the time. But if you start sprinkling them in, your body, you probably on the next run, you won't even feel those. You've run quickly, but you won't feel, you will have no negative experience from them. That's why I really like adding them as much as you like into your program. Across your training year, you can add lots of extra running at faster than your 5K speed by using strides. I did this a lot with our pro athletes that I coached. I wanted them to get much, much faster, but they were already training at really big volumes and lots of intensity across that. But I knew I could sprinkle in these strides, and if we looked across a season, a year, or an Olympiad for these guys, I could see, man, I'll get miles and miles and miles of extra fast running, but it won't fatigue them at all. It's a really great way to kind of get some additional training without them feeling like they were stressing their body and their mind too much. So I just wanted to put this video out there for those of you who want to improve your cadence, you want to improve your finishing kick, you want to get a little faster, feel faster, and maybe do better prep going into, say, a speed workout or a hill workout phase where you might be concerned about getting injured. Feel free to add strides anytime you like. Again, using common sense, keep them short, excellent form, fast turnover, learn to run quickly, and I think that give it, you know, 2 or 3 or 4 months, I think you'll really find that all of a sudden your running form improves, your average training pace may go up. It's a wonderful sort of trick where you get a big bang for very little stress on the body and the mind. So wanted to let you know, feel free to include those anytime you like. As always, if you have any questions about this, let me know, and I'll talk to you again real soon. Take care.